God has placed them and ordained them according to the spiritual ordination, according to the word of God. Meaning every pastor, every bishop, every teacher, every deacon must be familiar with the word of God. And they should be filled with the Holy Spirit of God. A teacher of the word of God has to be a clean vessel. They cannot be practicing witchcraft. They cannot be a practicing homosexual. They cannot be a practicing fornicator. They cannot be a practicing adulterer. They cannot be a practicing witch and be a teacher of the word of God. Because there will be no anointing. What they will be teaching is out of philosophy, sociology. Therefore, the word of God teaches us that whosoever shall exalt himself shall be obeyed, and he that the humble itself shall be exalted. But woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, ye hypocrites, for you shut up the kingdom of heaven against men, for you neither go in yourself, neither suffer them that are entering to go in. Meaning, if you think that you're going to go to church every Sunday for 40 years, and you don't understand what happened in the garden. You don't understand God's plan of salvation. You don't understand the biblical prophetic plan of God that God has laid out. And I will tell you, turn to this book, read one verse. Turn to the other book, read another verse. That is not a teacher of the word of God. That is humanistic philosophy. Man traditions. Sociology mixed with a little bit of dementia with its witchcraft. That is not a teacher of the word of God. They must be familiar and understand to understand the plan of salvation. And not quote this teacher, this man and that man and 200 years ago. No, you must teach the gospel of Jesus Christ. Not unto this gospel is teach. He cannot return. And many of them don't want God to return. They don't want Jesus to come back. So they refuse to teach you the word of God. So when you say, oh, yeah, my pastor may not be that right, but at least I get something out of it. What did you get out of it? When the word of God says, you're in verse 13 of the book of Matthew, the 23rd chapter, that your own pastor shut up the kingdom of heaven against them, against the people in the congregation, because they refuse to teach you the truth. And then, and so you need to go in yourself. Neither you suffer them that are entering to go in. You must have faith in God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You should have faith in your pastor. They worship their pastor every Sunday instead of worshiping God. Verse 14. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you devour widows' houses, and for pretense make a long prayer. Therefore you shall receive a greater damnation. All this praying. Corporate. What is this corporate stuff they're talking about? That ain't no spiritual warfare. That's an incantation. God said, let your yes be yes. All that we must enter to your prayer closet. All that blah, 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 blah. Repetitive chanting. Christians don't chant. Yahweh said, they said, Virgin Marie, you're chanting. It says here in verse 15, woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you compare sea and land to make one a proselyte. And when he is made, you make him twofold more the child of hell than yourself. Oh, we go to Africa. We go build a church in Africa. And then when they get over there to the foreign country, they say, okay, this is Christianity. We're surrounded by heathens. Let's pick one out of the bunch and leave them in charge over here. What they do, they deposit 7 more demons. They deposit legions of demons in that person, and they leave them there to spread more lies, to spread more false doctrine, to deceive the soul and to destroy the souls that should live, and make them die and go to hell, because they themselves will not enter into the kingdom of God. Verse 16, woe unto you, you blind guys, which say whatsoever shall swear by the temple, it is nothing. But whosoever shall swear for the gold that is in the temple is a debtor. Nina, you could curse the church, you could curse the temple, but you could curse the gold, because if you curse the gold, you gotta pay a fine. In 17, it says, you fools and blind, for what is greater the gold in the temple than the temple that sanctified the gold? Verse 18, and whosoever shall swear by the altar is nothing, but whosoever swear by the gift that is upon the altar is guilty. That means the altar where the Spirit of God is supposed to be, the Holy Spirit, you gonna curse the altar of God. But if you curse the gift that the person laid at the altar, then you're guilty, then you must pay a fine. You fools and blind, for what is greater, the gift or the altar that is sanctified the gift? Whosoever therefore swear by the altar, swear it by it, and all that the things that are thereon. As whoever swear by the temple, swear it by it, and by him that dwelleth therein. And he that shall swear by heaven, swear it by the throne of God, and by him that sitteth thereon. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! Woe unto you, bishops and pastors and elders, you hypocrites! For you pay tithe of mint and anise and cumin, and have omitted the word of matters of the law, which is judgment, mercy, faith. These ought you to have done, and not to leave the other undone. And you see that's happening today. It's all about materialistic teachings, a prosperity doctrine in the church. That's what it says here. Mint, things, they teach that you must have faith in God for things, for material things. And do whatever you want to do, live whatever lifestyle you want to live, commit adultery, divorce your husband, marry the deacon in the church, cheat on your wife, and your lascivious and your superfluity in the church, being prejudiced because of other people in your church and your congregation, talking about people's accent, people's national origin, and you call yourself a man and a woman of God. Woe unto you, you're a hypocrite. You was standing judgment before God. And then you teach that you must have faith in things and material things. But guess what? You wrong. We must have faith in God. You must have faith in the word of God. You must believe the word of God. You must have faith in Jesus Christ and the power of the Holy Spirit. Hypocrites. You blind guys, restrain a gnat and swallow a camel. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you make clean the outside of the cup and the platter, but within you are full of extortion and excess. Meaning that you are need to be a clean vessel. A clean vessel means repenting, making up your mind that you will no longer serve the God of this world, that you will no longer serve the devil. A clean, you must be clean, a clean vessel is a person who changed their evil, wicked ways and turn aside from sin. A sinner is supposed to repent if they really love God. If you really love God, you repent and you have a strong change of mind. And you start maintaining yourself clean. Clean from sinfulness, from adulterous, from fornication, from every wicked demonic that you used to do. The things you used to do, you stop doing them and you do them no more. But if you are not clean, you don't need to be on the altar. You don't need to be saying, Holy Spirit, come. Many of y'all be singing in church, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit. Y'all better be careful. Like one day the Holy Spirit don't really show up in there. And when the Holy Spirit show up, all of y'all start dropping dead in that church. Beware! God is not mocked. Whatever a man soweth, that shall he reap. I maintain myself pure. I'm a human being. I'm capable of sinning. I'm a sinner. But I repented for my sin. Like Paul said, and Elijah was a man of many passions. But guess what? Elijah prayed for 3.5 years and it did not rain. Then he prayed again and it rained. Faith.